Good morning, everybody. It's Monday. The sun is shining here in Northeast Ohio, and it's time for a little yoga. So grab your blocks, a blanket, a strap, and let's have some fun this morning. So I hope you have all of your props. Have a seat on your blanket. Make sure your blocks are handy, and you have your strap available as well. Teaching from home is challenging, I'll tell you that. I've learned a lot about myself and what I certainly need to improve on, and things that I'm happy. Yay, I can do it. So here we are. I'm speaking as loud as I can. I've got the volume way up. I hope everybody can hear me. And let's begin. So as you take your seat on your yoga mat this morning, pull the fleshy part of your sit bones out, roll your thighs back a little bit, and breathe. Just breathe. I'm gonna check the volume while you get settled, just to make sure. Hello, Heli Nero, it's good to see you, my dear. And I've got the volume way, 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 way up. As you feel your body settle onto the mat and your mind starts going a million miles an hour, because that's what we do, that's how we're made, I'm going to invite you to just notice your breath, notice your inhale and notice your exhale, and very consciously think about the breath, think about the way it feels when it comes into your body. Can you really feel it? Is it kind of quiet? How does it feel in your body this morning? How does your body feel today? It's a brand new day, brand new week. Are you tired? Are you feeling anxious? Are you kind of relaxed this morning? Do you have a busy day or a day to ponder? Notice your breath. Notice your breath. Notice your breath. Notice the inhale and notice the exhale. Notice what your body does when you are noticing your breath. Does your neck get tight? Do you get a little crease in between the eyebrows because you're concentrating really hard? It's always a little dance. Always a dance to find that balance of noticing breath but not really concentrating by contracting too much in any of the muscular tissue. And it's just a dance, finding the balance like we do every day in our lives, to stay present. We notice breath and we sit down a little deeper into the seat of yoga. Feel your sit bones resting on the floor, on your blanket, on your block, whatever they might be. Give your head a little nod, yes, and then a little wobble, I'm not sure, and just let it settle back down. Roll your shoulders up with an inhale and exhale them back down. And then just lift one shoulder, doesn't matter which one. Let that ear drop towards the shoulder. Take an inhale and an exhale. And then take it to the opposite side. Inhale and exhale. And do it again. Inhale, exhale, inhale, and exhale. Let your hands come down by your side, fingertips on the floor. And feel that length. Just softly close your eyes if you're comfortable with that, and feel the fingertips on the floor and follow that line up the arms. Notice if your shoulders feel locked. How can you unlock them? Maybe hug in a little more in the core, maybe in the upper torso, feeling the muscles around the chest cavity a little more. Soften the jaw. Keep your right fingers on the floor. Inhale the left arm up and over. Tip over to the right like a teapot. Take an inhale and lift a little bit. Exhale and drop over even more. Inhale, come back and settle the left hand back down. Inhale the right arm overhead. Exhale and tip over. Inhale to lift just a little bit. Exhale, tip over even more. Inhale, both arms come overhead. Hug into belly. Exhale, fingers release behind the back. Interlace and roll your shoulders back and down. Hands are interlaced behind you. Take a breath. Drop the chin down. Inhale and roll to the right. Exhale and roll down. Inhale, roll to the left. Exhale and release the chin back down. Very mindfully, inhale and lift the chin. Release your hands. Bring them back one more time to easy seat. Let the hands rest. And one more time, become aware of your breath. Notice the breath. Gently open your eyes and make your way into table pose, moving the blocks and the blankets off to the side. Bringing wrist creases underneath the shoulders and knees underneath the hips, curl or flatten the toes, it's your choice. Settle down into table pose and hug low belly in on purpose. Maybe kind of tuck the tailbone, coming into just the slightest bit of a cat pose, just a little. And then sink a little bit into a cow. We're not moving with breath yet. We're just kind of feeling our way into cat and cow. We do it so much. We take it so for granted. So today on Monday Funday, let's see if we can wake it up a little bit. So draw awareness to your tailbone, exhale and round the back. Inhale and curl. Coming into cow pose. So continue your cat and cow and play around a little bit. If just regular cat and cow feels good, stay with this. If you want to wiggle your hips around a little bit, if you want to make big circles, great big circles, no circles, half circles. Move with breath. Always staying with your breath. So whatever form of cat and cow you have decided upon, stay with that. Take one more round of whatever cat cow you have chosen. And let's all meet back in a neutral spine. Walk your hands just a smidge forward, not even a half a handprint. Just walk them up and out, just a little bit, preparing for down dog. Curl back. Take an inhale. Walk your toes in a little bit closer to your nose so you are in a shallow down dog. Look at your toes and kind of grip the mat with your toes. Bend your knees and stick your booty back. Hug in, keep the back strong. Finger pads are pressing down. And now release one heel to the floor, bend the opposite knee. Exhale and switch sides. Exhale and switch sides. Exhale, switch sides. Now lift both heels and release
both heels towards the earth, stretching long through the Achilles and the back body, waking up hamstrings, saying good morning, hug in. Inhale, walk yourself into plank pose. Keep breathing. Release your knees down to the earth. Come all the way down. Oh, I've disappeared. Inhale and lift into cobra pose. Exhale to release. Curl up. Find your way to child's pose. Knees wide, toes touch, or into puppy dog, either one. Keep breathing. Staying present. Staying present to you this morning. So challenging to just stay present. Inhale and rise back to your table. Draw your left foot forward. Reach for your blocks and bring them to whatever level works for you today. Lift the back knee, come into a high lunge, and lengthen through the left leg a little bit. Just taking a breath, exhale, release back to high lunge, hug in. And then exhale, release the right knee. Inhale, arms all the way up. Exhale, fingers come back down to the blocks, slide back. Ardha Hanuman, half split pose. Walk your blocks way forward. Find your breath. Inhale, rock forward, low lunge. Inhale to a high. Exhale and release, slide back. Inhale, rock it forward, come into high lunge. Keep your right hand on the block, left arm all the way up. Smile. Draw that left hip back just a little bit, sink down just a little bit. And release the left hand back down. Step forward with the back knee or jump switch, your choice. Stepping forward, bringing the opposite knee back. So for me, my right knee is forward, my left knee is back. Into high lunge, straighten with that right leg a little bit. Inhale, come back forward, lower the left knee down. Lengthen, get tall. Inhale, lift again, high lunge. Exhale to release, slide all the way back, Ardha Hanuman. Inhale, rise, come back to high lunge, beautiful. Exhale to release, low lunge, slide back, Ardha Hanuman. Half split pose, draw belly in just a little bit. Inhale, rise back up, lift to your high lunge, keep your left fingers on the block, bring that right arm high, keep breathing. Drop in a little bit deeper. Draw your right hip back. Keep breathing. Stay present. Release the right hand back down to the block and step your back foot forward. Inhale, rise all the way up, arms overhead. Exhale to prayer. Inhale, arms overhead. Exhale, soft forward fold. Fingers to the block. It's beautiful. Exhale deeper. Now while you're down there, if you have your strap, reach for your strap, rise all the way back up. I'll turn so you can see me. You can stay facing the top of your mat. Inhale, arms overhead. Find your length. Try to keep the back straight, belly hugging in, shoulders soft to the back. Bring the arms wide as your shoulders are comfortable with, and release over to the left. Inhale, come back to the middle and take it to the opposite side. Inhale your way back to the middle. Step your feet about a little wider than hip distance. Take a shallow bow. Inhale, rise back up. Take it again. Over to the left. Come back to the middle and take it to the right with an exhale. Stay with your breath. Come back to the middle, keep belly strong. Drop that right left arm behind you. Bend your right elbow and reach for the strap behind you with the opposite arm. So a little Gomukhasana, cow face.
on the top, strong legs on the bottom. Wait, breathe, feel the shoulders soften a little bit. Now drop over to the left and bend the right knee a little bit. Whichever elbow you have towards the ceiling, bend that same knee on the same side. Keep the shoulder dropping back. Keep the head in line with the body. Inhale your way back to the middle. Softly release all of that. Let it go. Lift the shoulders up. Bring the strap overhead. It's fun day, so bring it around however you want to. Inhale. We'll take it to the opposite side. Now the left arm is on top for me. Right arm is behind me. I'm just going to take it over to the right a little bit because it feels so good. This is my very tight side. I'm constantly working to keep this open and happy. Some days are good, some days aren't so good. Bending the left elbow, right hand comes behind. I come into that Gomukhasana, cow face on top. Breathe, beautiful Tadasana legs, core is engaged. Maybe you press your toes to the earth. Maybe you lift them, play with that a little bit, feeling your foundation. And exhale, tip over to the right. Bend the left knee a little bit, or whichever elbow you have to the sky, bend that knee. Inhale, release, unwrap, shake that all out. Take a nice wide step. So if you're still facing the top of your mat, for a moment, turn to the side. Inhale, arms overhead. Breathe. And now let's switch the arms. Bring the arms back down with an exhale. Take the strap behind you. How you hold the strap is between you and your shoulders. I'm going to turn, when I'm facing you, my fingers are facing towards you. Some of you may prefer to turn your fingers away. We're going to take that bow, bringing the arms overhead. Keep breathing. Bend the knees a lot, inhale, rise back up. Let it go. Beautiful. Turn to face the top of your mat again, please. Coming back to Tadasana. Inhale, arms overhead, exhale, forward fold, fingers come down, step back for a wonderful down dog. Inhale to a plank pose, roll onto the right knee, leg, open up for supported side plank. If you need a little support, bring that top foot in. If this is your jam and you want to take it deeper, lift the leg, lift the outside leg, play around. Exhale, come back to plank. We're going to turn and go the opposite way. I'm turning so you can see me, but we'll be on the left side. Open up. Breathe. Exhale, release back to plank pose. Lower to the earth, knees, chest, chin, chaturanga, find a bhujangasana, cobra pose. Maybe lift up into upward facing dog and then exhale, curl back, playing around a little bit. Meet me back in a down dog, inhale, lift the right leg, stack the hips, bend the knee. Find your breath, stay present. Exhale and release. Inhale with the left leg, stack your hips, bend your knee. Exhale to release. Inhale to plank, lower down to the earth, knees, chest, chin, chaturanga, your choice. Inhale, cobra pose, upward facing dog. Exhale, down dog. Inhale and lift the left leg, bring your left foot to meet your left hand, high lunge. Pivot the back heel down. Inhale, rise, warrior two. Breathe. Float a little bit in your down, in your warrior two. So you find that place for your knee. It's tracking towards the pinky toe. Belly is hugging in. And you feel supported. With soft shoulders. Inhale, find reverse. Exhale, come back to warrior two.
Interlace the fingers, turn towards the right corner of your mat, take a bow. Inhale, rise. Come back to warrior two. Lengthen the front leg, arms overhead, feel very tall. Exhale, open back up, warrior two. Hands come to the waist, lengthen the left leg, turn all your toes to the side, find a breath. Turn your right toes towards the front of your mat, bend the right knee, open it up, warrior two. Find reverse. Exhale, come back to warrior two, beautiful. Soften the top of the shoulders, interlace your fingers behind you, roll the shoulders back, bow to the inside. Release your fingers down to the earth, pivot the back heel up, lower the left knee down, your back knee, whichever one you have. Find a little lizard pose. Keeping the right foot happy or your front foot, whichever one is up there, let it roll a little bit to the knife edge. Let the knee drop away if that's okay with your knee. Find a breath. Lift a little bit, support yourself. Unwrap, bring the right hand to the outside of the right foot. Heel to the right foot in more to the center of your mat. Drop in a little deeper. This is kind of somewhere between a pigeon and a lizard. Keep the back leg a little engaged. Bend the elbows a little or a lot. It's between you and your hip. This is a deep, deep, deep hip opener. Find breath. Stay engaged everywhere. Stay present. Inhale, lift the hips, come into a funky little half split pose, sliding back. Come back to the middle and land in a low lunge. So we're gonna walk hands to the middle, lift back up to that wide leg forward fold, take a bow. Inhale to lengthen, walk around to the opposite side. Pivot the back heel up, drop the right knee down, coming in for lizard on this side. So my hands are to the inside of my front foot. I'm opening up the knee a little. It really is dependent upon how your hip and your knee are. Go where it works for you. Find length and stability in the back leg. Settle down. Smile. Bring your left hand to the outside of that left foot. Wiggle your foot more towards the middle of your mat, coming into that funky little somewhere between pigeon and lizard. Bend the elbows a little bit. Listen, listen, listen. Honor what your body can do on this side. Inhale and slide the hips back, coming in for a delicious Ardha Hanuman, half split pose. Inhale, make your way back to low lunge, lift to high lunge, hands to the earth, step the left foot back, find down dog. Inhale to plank and lower all the way to the earth. Take the back bend of your choice. Maybe you need to take a sphinx pose. Maybe you're all into it and you're going full guns, enjoy yourself. Exhale to release, inhale, make your way back to down dog. Make it a shallow dog. Walk your feet in so you get that lovely lengthening through the back of the legs. Staying in a little bit shorter down dog. Inhale, lift the right leg, stack your hips. Inhale, knee to nose. Exhale, settle into this rounded pose. Release. Inhale, lift the left leg, stack the hips, bend the knee. Exhale, knee to nose, curl in. Bring the left foot underneath your body and all the way across. Lower down onto the left hip for Iron Cross. Fingers come up. Support yourself. Press through the legs and the feet. Hug in. Gently begin to walk your hands behind you, coming into a very awkward twist. And then begin to bend the knees. Let the right leg rest in the arch of your left foot. Twist it around, breathe. Exhale and come out of this. We're gonna swing the legs around. Make your way into down dog. Beautiful. Inhale, lift your right leg and bring your right foot underneath, sliding down into Iron Cross on this side. See, that was my clever trick so I could stay facing you. Press through the heels, stay with your breath. Take an inhale and an exhale and begin to walk your hands behind you a little bit and then bend the knees. It's a little bit awkward, but it's fun and it's something different to try. Let the top leg rest in the arch of the right foot. Gently unwind. Hands come to the earth. Find your way into down dog. Bend your knees, look at your hands. Step, jump, crawl, fly up to meet your hands. Inhale, rise all the way up, arms overhead, exhale to prayer. Feel your body settle as you find your breath, and then look around for a block and a stretch. So I'm calling this Monday Funday, so we can all get a good laugh, I hope, and not take ourselves too seriously, because life is fairly serious out there. Let's enjoy this moment. So I have my block. I know it's hard for you guys to see where I am. But I have the block in front of my right foot, and I'm going to put my foot on top of the block, okay? I'm going to take my front hand, my right hand, and bring it to the inside of my right leg. I have a strap. I have it behind me, and I'm holding onto that strap under my left, my right leg, okay? So this is called Bird of Paradise. I know Jolynn knows the Sanskrit for it. I don't remember, so. There's my limited words for yoga. So here I am. I've got my foot on the block. My leg is very steady. My left leg, core is hugging in. You can stay right here. If you want, you can come up onto that left leg and lift the right foot, and you can extend the right leg. Soften the shoulders. Bend the right knee, release that foot, unwrap. And let's switch sides. For those of you that have this in your practice and you don't need a strap because you have beautiful long arms, don't use the strap. So here we are. I've got the left foot on the block. I'm going to hold the strap in my right hand, bring my right hand behind me, bring my left hand underneath, holding the strap. Begin to lift up. If you want to get long and strong in the core, holding on, lifting up, lengthening, smile, bend the left knee, release the foot, unwrap, and release. Let that go. I was inspired this morning by the birds that were very, very musical. They were really chirping outside my window today. It was lovely. Come back to your mat. Come back to your breath. Come back to Tadasana, hug belly in. Breathe. Neck is nice and loose. Beautiful. If you are not facing the front of your mat, turn around and go to the top of your mat. Inhale, arms overhead, exhale, and forward fold. Fingers come down to the block or to the earth. Step back, down dog. Inhale with the right leg. Exhale, right foot all the way up. Keep the left hand on the mat, right arm to the sky. Release the right hand to the inside. Walk yourself around to the left leg. Come into high lunge. Right hand stays on the earth, left arm to the sky. Release the left hand. Come back to your wide leg forward fold. Exhale and bow. Inhale, lengthen to a flat back. Walk yourself over to your right feet. Come on to the right toes. I'm balancing. Left foot comes into the air. Breathe. Hands can stay on a block. You can bring them up. Exhale to release your hands. Walk yourself over to the left. I'm balancing on my left toes. Breathe. Release your hands. Come back to that wide leg forward fold. Take a bow. You can release your forearms to the earth. Don't just relax and forget about it. Don't let this hinge from your hips. You want to hug in, keep the core engaged, keep your thighs engaged, rolling sit bones back. Inhale and lift the back of your heart. Walk yourself towards the top of your mat. Slide the front leg back, plank pose, lower all the way to the earth. Inhale and lift into cobra pose or upward facing. Take three rounds of breath. Slide back, puppy dog. Easy seat. Use your blanket if you like. Coming back to Sukhasana. Keeping both blocks available. Strap as well. Bring your left heel in towards your crotch and let your right leg come out to the side. Rock forward so you're sitting on your sit bones and sit back up. With your strap. Wrap it around the bottom of the right foot. Hold the strap in just the left hand. You can use a block and put it to the inside of the right foot or not. You can bring your right hand just to the inside of the right leg. Bring the left arm overhead. Find a little tilt over to the right. Lifting through the heart body. So you really got to tap into Anahata, heart chakra, Manipura, core. Soften the neck. As the body softens, maybe you walk your hand down the strap a little bit more, maybe not. Inhale and exhale. Inhale to rise back up. You can keep your hand on the strap if you like, or you can just bring your hand down to the earth, either on each side of your right leg. Use the leverage of your right hand to kind of encourage the body to turn towards the right foot. Maybe you bring your left hand over to your right leg, maybe not. Breathe. Inhale and rise all the way up. Exhale, hands to prayer. Without using your hands, switch your legs. Left leg comes out, right foot comes in. Now reach for your strap. Wrap it around the bottom of your left leg, holding the strap in your right hand. Bring the right arm overhead, left arm slides to the inside of the left leg. Keep breathing. With each exhale, maybe you go a little deeper, maybe you're where you need to be. Inhale to rise back up out of this. Turn your body towards the extended leg. A hand on each side of that long leg. Use the outside arm behind you, the left arm, to lift you and open you up on that left side. Coming in, maybe you bring your right hand to the outside of the left leg to help a little more, maybe not. Inhale to rise back up, arms come overhead. Bring the left leg in, coming back into Sukhasana. Now bring the feet together. Exhale, hands to prayer. Take an inhale and an exhale, take a bow. Come back to your breath. Notice the inhale and the exhale. Inhale to rise back up. Bring your legs long in front of you into Dandasana, staff pose. Shake out the legs. Inhale, arms overhead. Exhale and turn to the left. Inhale, come back to the middle. Exhale to the right. Inhale, come back to the middle. Exhale, hands to prayer. Bend the right knee. Inhale, arms up. Now take a twist to the right. Left hand to the outside of the right knee. Right hand behind you. Draw belly in. You can bring the elbow to the outside of the right leg or rest the hand. Whatever helps you, come into the pose. Keep the left leg engaged. Take an inhale, and as you exhale, turn your chin to the left. Belly in. Inhale, arms overhead, switch legs. And as you exhale, come into your twist on the side. Bring the elbow or the hand or the arm to a place that works. Keep the right leg engaged. Exhale and turn your chin to the right. Again, lift up, lengthen both legs. Hands come down. Maybe you take your strap and you wrap it around the bottom of your right, of both feet. Hug in. Keep the legs engaged. Lift through the heart. Hug belly in. Gently release all of that. Come off of whatever you're sitting on and make your way down onto your back. Bring your legs straight up. Roll your shoulders down your back. Bring your arms out to the letter T and drop your knees to the right, your legs to the right. Inhale to the middle and exhale to the left. Inhale, come back to the middle, exhale to the right. Inhale to the middle, exhale to the left. Make your way back to the middle. Keep your tailbone rooted down. Find an arch in your back. Bring your arms straight out. Plug the shoulders in. Hug in. And now hug into the midline. Squeeze your face like you just ate a lemon. Take an inhale. And exhale, drop the feet to the earth, cross your right leg over the left, pick up your hips, move them to the right and drop your knees to the left. Release your right arm to the side. Roll your chin to the right. Inhale your way back to the middle, uncross. Cross the left leg over the right. Hips move to the left, knees to the right, open up to the left, your arm and your chin. Inhale and come back to the middle, uncross your legs. Lift the hips, come in for a bridge pose. Exhale, lower back down to the earth, reach for a block and bring the block underneath your hips. Lift up into bridge, lift your legs up, coming in for a supported shoulder stand. For my folks that like to do full inversions to end your practice, please feel free to do that. Take your shoulder stand, take your plow pose, be mindful and hug in. Enjoy the ride. And as you exhale, softly release, come back down. If there is a last pose that you want to take, by golly, take it. Come all the way down to the earth once you have completed that and make your way into Shavasana, the hardest pose in yoga. As you settle down into your Shavasana, bring your feet a little bit wide, let your hands rest by your side. Eyes are soft or closed. Breath is easy. Take a moment to think about your practice this morning. Smile at yourself at how easy it is to get distracted, even when we're trying to stay present to practice yoga. We're only human. Notice your inhale and your exhale. Be at peace with whatever is and is not. Wiggle your fingers and your toes. Bend your knees. Roll to one side or the other. Stay with your breath. Make your way up for an easy seat. Find a smile. One more time, tap into your breath. Bring your hands to prayer. Thank you so much for sharing Monday morning Funday practice with me. May you be well, may you be richly blessed, and may you always know peace that surpasses all understanding. Our practice is now complete. Namaste. Love you all.